The cost of the unit has been increasing quarter by quarter, which has left islanders on Bugala Administrative Island worried, as Richard Chiganda narrates.
I affected due to high prices of power supply, and almost the cost of power is too high.
Currently, domestic consumers buy a unit at 1,290.6 shillings from the previous 1,094.0 shillings. Commercial consumers buy a unit at 1,689.2 shillings from the previous 1,407.0 shillings. Julius Mukasa Opondo narrates how business owners are affected by high tariffs.
Down there at the beach, you can use something like 100,000 in 3 days on a three phase. I have 15 rooms so far. The others I'm just constructing. But I'm wondering the expenses.
However, power currently is not reliable, yet the company promised to avail it 24/7. Honorable Helen Nachimli asked KIS officials to explain.
Businessmen and women on this island who use your power or your electricity, but they say it is on and off. When it is on, people who have fridges, they work. But those who have fridges and it is off, they don't work.
Do amend to provide for wider latitude, scope of coverage. What should we be doing as your members of parliament to widen the scope of your coverage?
Rajab Semakula, the Kalangala district chairperson, said that sometimes they doubt the process of determining power prices. But according to John Opondo, the managing director of Kalangala Infrastructure Services, high power tariffs are being influenced by fuel prices, which have been high, yet they use both solar and generators.
That may be you connive to reach that rates, because it is not synchronizing. You say you rely more on generators, and the generators, you say that the rates for fuel are high. Now that the rates are for fuel are decreasing, still the current rates we have increase.
Are we seeing unreliable power? When the government floated the idea of a marine camp, the community here, including the leadership then, was against it, because at that time our power here was on 24/7.
John Opondo further narrated that power physics requires them to generate twice the would-be supplied power.
Generation and distribution, particularly transmission and distribution. When you have long lines and low load at the end, the system demands for more power. So you end up with a situation where, in the actual sense, the load you have is 400.4 megawatts, but because of the physics of power, transmission and distribution, you find that you have to generate twice that amount of power.
Power tariffs are usually determined by the Electricity Regulatory Authority, and for Kalangala, prices are determined quarterly. Kalangala Infrastructure Services Limited have promised that the tariffs will be lowered since the cost of fuel is decreasing. Report compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news.